Week number 13 in the National Football League. Ladies and gentlemen, you are watching World of Matchups, NFL Handicapping Podcast, coming to you guys live and direct from Las Vegas, Nevada. I am Dexter Reed, your host. On the other side of the glass, my A1 from day one and producer of WOM. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome in Spencer the Wiz. Happy Thanksgiving, bro, and all that. What up?
Yeah, happy Thanksgiving. I don't know. Yeah, that game yesterday was very interesting. The Chiefs Raiders game. I know you were traveling, so I don't know if you got to see it, but
I almost had my plane make an emergency landing, bro.
That was pretty nuts, man. I don't agree with the call at the end of the game. I think that's horrible officiating. The guy runs in for a false start. They huddle, and then suddenly it's not a dead ball, even though everybody on the field except for the guy who nonchalantly grabs the fumble does. You know, he doesn't fling himself onto it like the Super Bowl's on the line. He's just like, well, I guess I'm here. Like every dead ball player does in the entire National Football League. I don't get that, man. That's just how it is. But, you know, it ended up working. It obviously works out best for the Raiders because they're sliding up the draft board. So, I mean, it was the best outcome for the Raiders in that situation. But just another example of horrible officiating in the National Football League.
Oh, it's absolutely horrendous. The NFL is absolutely horrendous. Why do we still do this? You know what I mean? Like,
these huddle calls, man, are just the worst. Like when you know when a group of referees are huddling together, you're going to get the most dog water decision you've ever heard.
Well, there's somebody calling in from New York or Las Vegas. Let's be honest. I mean, I got home. I flew late last night. And so I really haven't had a chance to dissect it as much as you probably have. I came home, went to bed, woke up, and I'm doing the show with you. But basically what I believe should happen in that time frame is like a full-on blown out drag out explanation should be taking place. You know what I mean?
Didn't even like show it.
There should be
like all right,
multiple
let's get
angles. I mean, you see it after the fact. I watched it a bunch of different times after the game, but to end the game like that, I'm not so sure, honestly, if it was the right call or the wrong call. I'm just not. I don't know. But as a Chief fan, I'll take the win. The Chiefs looked absolutely horrendous.
As a Raiders fan, I'll take the loss, too. So.
Yeah, the Raiders, I mean, it helps everybody. I'm not even going to talk about the Chiefs today. I'm just going to leave it at that. And we'll come back to them next week because I'm not really feeling what's happening right now in Kansas City. But we have a Week 13 slate to go over. And so we're going to set it off for you guys, try to make you guys some money. Spencer and I have been pretty good lately, man.
Yeah.
We've been hitting almost double digits every week. So hopefully you guys aren't losing your houses and your wedding rings, but you're actually putting a little bit of money aside for Christmas. Set it off with who's first, Spence.
Yeah, we have the Falcons and Chargers here in to start the 10 o'clock slate. This is a decent game. You know, it's kind of hard to call, and obviously the line is -1 in favor of the Chargers. So, you know, the books agree that this is going to be a very close contest. I'm going to just go Chargers. I mean, I've been on the Falcons pretty much all year, and if this feels like one of those games where everyone's going to be on the Chargers and then suddenly the Falcons have the best performance of the season, but I don't know. I just kind of just don't trust it. They've been really, like, on a downward trend for a good time now, so I guess I'd rather wait for them to prove it to me than me just, like, lose and keep depending on them to, like, live up to their potential. That's just kind of how I feel about it. The Chargers defense should have a really good game here. Although it just makes me nervous. That Bengals game makes me so nervous, man. I just really that changed my perception of the Chargers defense. Mm-hmm. I know the Bengals offense is super high powered. Like I know that. But man, it was just a shootout. And I guess some games just end up kind of being like that. We'll see, but I would like to say that the Chargers defense plays really good this week and kind of, you know, keeps that Falcons team in check, and they just win one of those stupid grind out kind of games, like 20-17. That's kind of how I could see it going down.
When I have games like this, I'm going to take the home dog in their building. That's the more desperate team. I'm taking the Falcons. I'm probably going to take them with a decent amount of confidence here too, Spencer, for a number of different reasons. One, this is their season. They lose this game, they're a 500 football team. All this talk about them going to the playoffs and going deep into the playoffs and making a run now that they've got Kirk Cousins back there, it all goes out the window. Like, literally, this is a playoff game for them at home versus a team that just got destroyed in their own building, and they lost one of their key pieces in J.K. Dobbins. J.K. Dobbins is going to be out for a couple weeks now. Okay, the annual J.K. Dobbins injury in December, here it is, folks. I mean, it's like death, taxes, and J.K. Dobbins gets hurt. And so for that reason, I'm going to take the Falcons. I know the Chargers' defense is good, but we saw them get picked apart on Sunday Night Football. We both had the Chargers in that game, but then I went and laid some money on the Ravens and got paid. I mean, you just can't make this stuff up. I got talked into it. But I think when you have to fly, I think when you're missing a key piece of your running game that catches passes, so now that eliminates a part of your offense that you would sorely need in this game. And quite frankly, I'm a little bit down on the Chargers. I know they've played well. I don't know if it's those blue unis that they never win in. I don't know what it is. But this is the more desperate team. Bijan Robinson really needs to have that Bijan Robinson game that you just haven't seen this year. He's been good. He's been good. But at no point has he been fantastic. And that's what you pick this guy to be. And I don't think they're using him like they need to. I say you run the ball right at LA here. Go right into the teeth of that defense. You saw what Derrick Henry did to them. Do that, and it should be a close 2-3-point win. I can see a young Waku field goal to win this game at home for Atlanta, and it keeps their playoff hopes alive. Take the Atlanta Falcons with a decent amount of confidence, and I think you'll eat here, guys.
All right, let's jump over to the Steelers going to Cincinnati. Yeah, Cincinnati is 3-point favorites in this game. I really don't like that. I mean, I'm not the biggest fan of the Chargers, but I don't know. What have the Bengals done this year to prove that they should be favored against anybody? Exactly. I mean, they're the kings of finding ways to lose games. I mean, legitimately, like, you just know they're going to do something to ruin their chances. So I like the Steelers. I think they have a very good chance of winning this game. Certainly covering a field goal, I could easily see happening. Like, you know, maybe you buy a half point for the Steelers or something to make yourself feel really comfortable about the bet. I don't know, but I don't know what Cincinnati, besides, you know, having a decent offense, has shown, because I think the Steelers are going to be able to put up points against them. And if the Steelers can score 20 points, they're going to win the football game. That's just the nature of their defense. They can get to that 20-point mark. I feel so confident, man. And I really do think they can. I mean, the only reason, let's be honest, the Bengals are 4-7 is because they have one of the worst defenses in the entire National Football League.
They're horrible.
You know, I know that they, you know, they have to basically cover extra possessions because the Bengals are scoring so much. But you see it. They get diced. And it doesn't matter. Running the football, passing. I mean, they have to be at the bottom of both of those averages. So I think the Steelers are going to eat up the clock here in this game because that's what they do. And this is almost a good archetype game for them to have. They're going to run the ball a gazillion times. The Bengals won't be able to stop them. They're going to get a bunch of first downs. And then you look up in the clock and, you know, the Bengals will try to drive to you know, win the game down like 14-20 or something. And they just won't happen. They'll get it'll be a bad sack. Game over. I mean, I can just see that happening in this football game.
Me too. This is one of my favorite bets this week. It's not going to be my best bet, but it's high up there, man. Steelers coming off a loss are house money. Versus a team that's got a bad defense that cannot protect Joe Burrow. Boy, Joe Burrow gets tossed around like a rag doll. I mean, I know they went and signed Amarius Mims in the offseason. They drafted the kids like 6'8", 400. It hasn't helped. I mean, every time you look around, Joe Burrow's on the floor. And it's bad. You know what I mean? I know Chase Brown has come on and emerged. Jamar is always going to be one of the top three wideouts in the league. T. Higgins is making his case to get paid. Fine. But, like, you can't win a game like this with four players. You can't. And Pittsburgh will run the ball. Third and 20, Pittsburgh will run the ball. They're going to force you to stack the box and stop them. That's what they're really good at. Russ has been better than advertised. To me, that snow game in Cleveland was an anomaly, man. You toss that out. I mean, the weather conditions kept the Steelers from winning that game, in my mind. So when you multiply all these things, add them up, and write them down, it's a convincing Steelers win. And then you're going to give me 3 points? Let anything happen to Joe Burrow, the game is over. It's over. I mean, the Cincinnati Bengals are the most overrated team in the National Football League. Everyone still talks about them at 4-7 like they're in the playoff hunt. Okay, so they match up well with Kansas City, but you're never going to see Kansas City at 4-7. You know what I mean? So, like, why are we having this discussion? What we should be talking about is a dysfunctional franchise that can't protect their $500 trillion asset. That's what you're talking about, who's about to lose one of the biggest pieces on their team. To me, they're very overrated, and I think the Steelers are very underrated. Mike Tomlin wins 10 games every year. He goes to the playoffs every single year. Russ has been very, very good. Take the Steelers plus the 3 points. This is one of my favorite bets, man. I feel really good about it, actually. Let's roll with it.
Yeah, I like that one too a lot. We have the Texans going to Jacksonville. I don't know what the status of Trevor Lawrence is in this game. I have a feeling he's going to play. Oh, really?
I think he's going to play. I'm pretty sure I saw somewhere while I was on vacation that I got a notification that he's going to play.
Wow.
Let me see if I can find some information while you speak.
Yeah, this is a really tough game. These are two teams that are not trending in the right direction, which is crazy to say because Houston, you know, 7-5, which is pretty darn good. But man, it doesn't look like they're gonna. This looks like a team that's gonna flail out in like the wild card round. I mean, that's just kind of the impression that I'm getting from them right now. But Jacksonville's so bad. This is easily one of the toughest games to call, and not because of anything good. But, you know, I'm just going to take the Texans. It's -3.5. They're due for a good game. They have a good team. And if you're going to have a good game against somebody, and I know it's a division rival, so that's always kind of funky. And I've been really riding this division rival wave recently. But sometimes, in my opinion, some of these things can be transcended. The Jaguars have absolutely no reason to win. In fact, they should do anything to maintain that first overall pick because they will be getting calls from so many teams to sell it. Or, I mean, they could just keep it and go after Travis Hunter. But if you're sliding up from like the 2-3 spot, you're getting a bunch of picks. The QBs are going to be taking 1-2, you know, and then you can pick whoever you want. I mean, that is just like it's a franchise altering position to be in. And that does not happen every year. I mean, think about the year that the Jaguars picked number one overall last time. It was a linebacker who wasn't even that good. I mean, Aiden Hutchinson was like the star player in the top 10. And I know he's good, but that was the conversations we were having where it's like, you know, a borderline star.
Not that good, yeah.
Yeah, but that was the draft that year. It's not like that this year. Having the number one overall pick is 10 times more valuable. And as of right now, that's where they're at. So I'm not saying these guys are going to go out there to lose because no player who's actually on the field playing, you know, is going to play to lose because they care about their franchise. They care about their jobs, but that doesn't mean the coaching staff can't put in certain guys in certain positions where they know, you know, they have a better chance to lose if this guy plays. And you can put it under any guise, you know, I want to see the young guys play more, yada, 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 you know, running certain schemes, doesn't matter. I just have a feeling, man, that Jaguars front office is salivating at the chance to get that first overall pick. And the Texans are on the other side of that, being that they really need to win this game, and they need to win it in convincing fashion to convince themselves. In fact, I'm going to make this my best bet. I mean, I really think that the Texans, if they can't cover 3.5 against the 2-9 Jaguars, I'm not going to say their season's over, but, man, it would just about be over if they cannot have a convincing win here.
I'm going to play devil's advocate, guys, and I'm going to give you the other side of this coin. So, Doug Peterson, he's coaching for his job. He's coaching for his job. Shad Khan is one of those owners that wants to win. He wants to win, period, okay? If it was a live tank, okay, Trevor Lawrence wouldn't be starting. They're expecting Trevor Lawrence to go tomorrow. They would find a reason to hold Trevor Lawrence out, okay? If we're trying to just get picks, stockpile picks, it's all about 2026, Trevor, just sit. You know what I mean? Throw Mac out there. We're gonna sit Mac. We'll roll Tank out there. We're going to sit Travis. You know what I mean? Like, it's a live tank, but they can only do so much to make it look like a tank. Not only that, these guys are getting paid a lot of money, man. They're going to want to win. They're going to play for pride. I've watched this Jaguar team be valuable soldiers for me 3 out of 4 times versus playoff teams. The only time they got absolutely murdered was the last time out. They got drubbed. But I'm not going to go away from them here because I don't think the Texans are that good. If you take Joe Mixon off the Texans, they're less than a .500 team. there's a real sophomore slump that's happening right now with C.J. Stroud. Guys, they're not that good. They're not that good. Nico Collins, C.J. Stroud, and Joe Mixon are good. The rest of the team has been hot dog water this year. They're not good at all. Lose Stephon Diggs. You cannot minimize how big that loss is. On the road, dude, I just watched this team lose at home to the Titans, who are disgusting. Will Levis, mayonnaise-eating Will Levis and the Titans cost me my 16 parlay. At home, you lose that game? I'm sorry, bro. No. This is a fraudulent team. Everyone's trying to tell me that Houston's going to the playoffs and making a noise. This Houston team this year is not as good as last year's Houston team. Home dogs pay dividends. I'll take a shot with the Jags because 9 out of 10 times this year when I've taken a shot with them, what has happened? They have covered. So I'm going to take a shot here. These guys are going to play for pride, and I think, honestly, this coach knows that Shot Khan will get rid of him. There are guys out there, Bill Belichick, Mike Vrabel, Ben Johnson. There are coaches out there to be had, and Shot Khan's pocketbook is as deep as anyone. He will just be like, all right, you're fired, and he will bring one of these guys in. He's coaching for his life tomorrow. Jags plus 3.5 is the play.
Now we have the Arizona Cardinals are traveling to Minnesota. This is such a tough game, man, because Minnesota doesn't do it in like impressive fashion most of the time, but they do find ways to win these games, obviously. And that 9-2 record indicates that.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a really short line, too. The Cardinals are such a hard team to call. I mean, they're 500 for a reason. It's like, it's literally like they flip a coin when they get out of the tunnel to decide if they're going to win the game or not. I mean, it's like you're not watching the same team. You know, watching Kyler Murray like roll out to the right in that Seahawks game and throw a horrible pick six. It's weird to see that. And then when they're clicking, it looks like they're the best offense in the NFL sometimes. So Minnesota is a tough place to play, but in this game, you're getting 3.5 for the Cardinals. I mean, it wouldn't be out of this world to me to see the Cardinals win this game. I don't think it'd be the biggest upset in the world. And I think the Vikings are kind of due for a letdown, in my opinion. And it just seems like whenever the Cardinals, especially now, considering whenever they take a bad loss, it's like, well, it looks like they're going on the downward trend. And then they play a good game again. So I feel like that trend is going to continue. And also there is a little bit of a desperation factor here for the Cardinals. I mean, they got to win this game to keep up in the division. So if they go 500, it's like purgatory, especially in their division, you know. And they want to be chasing after that wild card spot. I'm not doing with a huge amount of confidence, but I think the Cardinals can cover a field goal in this game.
You'd like to think so. They just gave James Conner just now, guys, a contract extension, 2 years, $19 million, which is interesting to me because he's an older running back who was always hurt at 29 to get a 2-year deal. So they'll be fired up. He'll be fired up. This is a tough game for them, though. I've been betting against the Vikings. I've been winning a little bit, but, you know, at the end of the day, they are winning. They're not covering spreads. They're like Kansas City, but they're winning. Mm-hmm. And they're home. You saw last week TJ Hockenson start to look like TJ Hockenson. And what's happening with them is that they are letting everyone else eat, and they're letting you double jets. But the problem here is that everyone else can eat. Jordan Addison is very, very good. He's an underrated player. Hawk is back now. AJ is good. They have good players, man. So double jets, you're still going to pay. And I think that this is a resounding Viking W. I mean, I know you like the Cardinals plus the 3.5 here. I can't trust the Cardinals here plus 3.5. I really can't. I watched Kyler Murray throw one of the worst passes last week in Seattle.
And
it cost them the game. That was Daniel Jones-like decision-making. They were in the game. They were in the game, and it cost them the game. Vikings D is good. Brian Flores has done a one. Let's see. Brian Flores is not getting his flowers for the Vikings D. Okay, so we're going to take a second, and we're going to shine on him because what he has done with this defense is – it's mind-blowing. I mean, they got older players too, man. I mean, Gilmore is like a corpse. And they're running these guys out there, and they're making big strides week in and week out. They're the playoff team. They're the playoff team. And they're going to play hard here, man. I think they're going to hit 10 wins tomorrow, and I don't think it's going to be particularly hard. I'm taking the Vikings minus the 3.5, and I'm taking them with confidence here. I haven't seen MHJ do much this year, and he was supposed to be this amazing rookie. They're going to force James Conner to run through some tight holes while they're going to stack the box. Vikings are a good bet here. I know that hook scares you. If it scares you, buy the hook.
All right, now we have the Indianapolis Colts going to New England. It's only 2.5 for the Colts, so to me it's a little straightforward. And I know the Patriots are due for like a good game every once in a while, but the Colts are very desperate, and I feel like they're going to want something. I mean, after last week's performance, yeah, where they left a lot on the field, man. In that Lions game, there were so many times where I thought that they like were going to get it, you know, not necessarily win the game, but that score is not really indicative of like really what happened, that 24-6 loss. I mean, could have easily been like 16 or 20-24. A lot of bad penalties for the Colts that week. Tons of just big chunk plays were erased off the face of the planet. And I think that's just going to leave a bad taste in their mouth, man. I don't know, man. New England does not do anything for me. And the Colts obviously kind of have to have this feeling that they can still win this year or like make the playoffs. You know, they can't, obviously 5-8's the end of your season. 6-7. You know, that just, it's something to fight for. You know, it's like they're a little bit closer. They got 5 games
to do it, but they can.
Yeah. Yeah, so I like it, especially because it's not 3.5. It's only 2.5. And the Colts should win this game, not in resounding fashion, but, you know, just like one of those 23-16 kind of garbage nonsense games. You know, the Patriots score late, but it's not enough. Like, it's just kind of how it feels. I think the Colts defense is good enough because once the Patriots offense gets shut down, they got nothing going for them, man. Like, absolutely nothing at all. So I like the Colts in this game. I really do.
Me too. Colts are one of the better defenses in the NFL. They did leave a lot of points on the field last week. I thought they would be in that game. I thought they could potentially, you know, pull an upset and win that game. I mean, 24-6, when you play the Lions, that's almost like a win because the Lions are putting up tons of points. But they just didn't have it last week. This is a good game for them to get right on. Pats, they're valuable soldiers sometimes. They're not valuable soldiers every week. This is one that I want to feel good about, but I think Anthony Richardson is still better than people think he is. Has he had a rough year? Yeah, he's had some rough patches here, but I think they're going to give every indication that he's their guy moving forward, and they're going to let this 5-game streak play out with him and see what they can do. If this was 3.5, I'd be taking New England, but I'm going to take the Colts minus the 2.5. Field goal wins you money. Yes, it's on the road, but it's not snowing in New England yet. You know what I mean? Like, it'll be cold. I've seen the Colts win games like this weird before. They still have decent players. Alec Pierce, Jonathan Taylor hasn't done much this year. It's time for him to really just get the ball 30 times and see what he can do. And this could be the day, man. I do like what the Patriots are doing moving forward for the future. But it's the future. Control Drake May here, and the Colts should... they should win this game going away. Colts minus 2.5 is the play.
All right. We have the Seattle Seahawks going to New York to play the Jets. Ugh. You know, it's... this does not feel like the game that the Seahawks were like... it's just easy. You know, they get a nice one at home last week. Oh, man, it's just like the Jets seem foolproof of, like, any sort of narrative, don't they? Like, they're just so bad that...
the Jets are garbage.
They transcend space and time, you know, just not...
garbage.
Nothing is logical when it comes to the New York Jets.
They are garbage, bro.
Oh, man, it just does feel... like, the Seahawks did this earlier when it came to that Giants game. And they were at home for that Giants game, which makes it... that really was. We talked about it last week. It is the worst.
The worst home loss in the National Football League this year, Spencer. When the Giants went to Seattle without Malik Nabers, and who else were they missing?
Devin Singletary was out in that game too.
They had nobody, and they had a fully healthy Seattle roster and lost that game. That is the worst loss. That's the worst loss. Forget home loss. That's the worst loss in the NFL this year. That's worse than the Raiders beat the Ravens in their building.
That's the
worst one. Seattle does stuff like that.
I know, and it feels like this is another one of those games where they'll do that. But you know what, man? The Jets are just so bad. You know, it's like I cannot see Seattle having two losses to this level in one season. I mean, it would make last week even more frustrating for me because I was on the Cardinals. Like, I think the Cardinals should have won that game. But, you know, I'm not betting on the Jets for the rest of the season unless there's a ridiculous line, unless it's something stupid. This is a 1-point spread. I need the Seahawks to win this game. The Jets are awful. Like, when you watch them, they just, like, they're talking about benching Aaron Rodgers for the rest of the season. I mean,
they should.
He's already halfway out the door. He's such a tool, man. Aaron Rodgers is the biggest tool ever.
He's the biggest douche in all of sports. If they bench Aaron Rodgers, the Jets would play better. You guys can at me all you want. This is a fact.
Yeah, they had that kid from Florida State that they drafted. If I was them, dude, I would be very interested in playing him in this
game. Look what they did last year with a mash unit of quarterbacks in New York. They played better then than they're playing now.
I like how they didn't fire their offensive coordinator either. They demoted him. I mean, this is just such a terrible organization. I'm going to take the Seattle Seahawks, man. I know this is one of those games where you should take the Jets, but I really do think the Jets are that bad. I think they are that awful that it'll transcend trends.
I can't do it. I don't know. I promised myself I would never bet the Jets again, but it's just win, baby. You know what I mean? It's just win, baby, at home. I was just in New York. The Meadowlands is going to be cold. I mean, Seattle flying across the country, coming off a humongous win. Everyone's going to take them here. Everyone's going to take them here, man. Home dogs pay dividends. I mean, is Aaron Rodgers this bad? Breece Hall's got a banged-up knee. I mean, free Garrett Wilson. Davante Adams is just an old man now. I mean, everything is pointing to Seattle money line. And that's what everyone's going to do. And so I'm going to take the Jets here on some Jesus nonsense, on literally the heavens opening and, like, you know, a field goal goes through on a Holy Spirit field goal to win the game. And everyone is now galvanized about Aaron Rodgers. I mean, they're talking about him not coming back. I mean, this is just an absolute mess. Like, you'd have to be an idiot to bet on the Jets here, right? But every time someone goes all in one way, I'm going the other way, man. Especially when that team is at home and all they have to do is win. This is what I know. Jet fans are going to be in the stands tomorrow. They will be in the stands. That's what they do. Same thing for the Giants. They sell out, even when the team is horrendous. So there's that. And the Jets still have decent players, man. Geno Smith, to me, is a tale of two quarterbacks. He's the gift and the curse. He's Jekyll and Hyde. When he's good, he's like, oh my goodness. He's the guy that, like, beats the 49ers on the road. But when he's bad, he loses at home to Daniel Jones and no one. I could see a world where that happens here. I'm going to take the Jets, not with a lot of confidence, only because everybody else is going to take Seattle, and I like to see everyone lose their money while I go eat pizza.
All right. Last game of the morning slate is the Tennessee Titans going to the Washington Commanders. Yeah, dude, that Commanders game was so easy to call last week. I mean, it was written all over it, man. I could just see the game.
That was the one of the best bets I made last year. I mean, this year. Commanders aren't 10.5 points better than anyone in the National Football League. Nobody.
That's a 5.5 point spread in this game.
I love the Titans here.
I'll be honest, I do too. I mean,
I love the Titans here, dude.
Despite being a 3-win team, they remind me a lot. They remind me a lot of the Raiders. Where it's like, yeah, they are 3-8, but, like,
they play hard every week, man.
I'm talking like three, you know, we're talking about like maybe 10 plays between both teams, like 10 plays for both teams that change the entire trajectory of their season. You know, like, think about the Raiders game yesterday, and you can do that for the Titans too. If one singular play, like, goes their way,
if Carson hits one field goal,
Yeah, they're fighting for a playoff spot. And the Titans haven't necessarily had like that kind of season, but pretty damn close. I mean, close. They play very competitive. And I think Washington's headed in the wrong direction. Jaden Daniels definitely is heading in the wrong direction. Mm-hmm. His season is taking a little downward trend, but it's a rookie, so it's not like...
Bo Nix is going to win Rookie of the Year.
Brock Bowers deserves it, in my opinion, but...
You're going to see Bo Nix win it, and he's going to cement it on Monday night. You heard it here first, folks. It's not Jaden Daniels peaked too early. He peaked too early. They needed to go get Devontae Adams. They need to go get T. Higgins. They need another receiver. Jaden Daniels is great, but since that rib injury, he has not been the same, dude. I'm telling you right now, this is a fantastic bet. I love the Titans here. I love the Titans here.
At 5.5 seems like too much, and I think the Titans could win this game. I think
that's
they could
too much. That's, dude, before yesterday, or Thursday, I should say, there's a real argument for the Titans being every bit as good as the Dallas Cowboys. And the Dallas Cowboys were getting 10.5. They're getting 10.5. Dude, this is disrespectful. They just went into Houston and won the game outright.
Yeah.
This should be like a 3-point spread. Will Levis is playing well. I'm sorry, you guys who are not Will Levis lovers, who do not believe in Will Levis, go look at his numbers. He is not blowing the roof off the stadium, but he has made his case of him being the starting quarterback for Tennessee next year. He's played well.
His decision-making sometimes.
The decision, he needs crazy. Better. He needs better coaching. You know what Will Levis needs, honestly? He needs Mike Vrabel.
I know.
If Will Levis had Mike Vrabel, the Titans could be a playoff team. Getting rid of Mike Vrabel was the single worst decision in the history of Tennessee Titan football. Period. And you're going to give me 5.5 with Tony Pollard running the ball the way he is. Nick Westbrook-Ikhine has emerged. They got decent tight ends. Calvin Ridley is still good when you can get his head together. Dude, what have they done to be 5.5 favorites? You lost the game outright versus a horrendous Dallas team on some of the worst special teams play I've seen all year long. Titans plus 5.5 is the play. You guys do what you want to do. I'm a touchdown Titans type of guy this week.
Yeah. Tampa Bay, they are going to Carolina. This was another game that had a pretty strange line, like a weird six. Yeah, six is a strange
5.5. I got them at.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It obviously depends on the sports book, too. So. Yeah,
I use the score well.
Gosh, I don't know. Hey, first of all, let's just say Bryce Young is the quarterback for the Carolina Panthers.
I mean, played well.
Back now. He has earned his spots 100%.
Everybody is playing well versus the Chiefs secondary right now.
Everybody. he's had a decent run, Bryce Young, in the last like few weeks. So that goes without say that he has secured his spot. He's going to be the starting quarterback for them next year, and they're going to like move forward as a franchise. You know, there was obviously when he got benched, it's another Trey Lance, man. He's just going to fade into obscurity, you know, get traded as a backup somewhere, and you'll never hear about him ever again. But, dude, in that Chiefs game, man, he made some great throws.
He made throws that Tom Brady would make. He made 2019 Mahomes throws. I was like, God. I mean, I'm talking like 3rd and 8 with a guy on your arm with a 2-inch window for the ball to go in on the sideline. I mean, he was throwing dimes. I was like, is that Bryce Young? Like, Bryce Young is back. He's going to be good for them. They need to give him some more help, but he's going to be good for them.
Yeah, this makes me, it really makes me want to take Carolina. And I think almost everybody is, but
not me.
Gosh darn, man. Tampa Bay, dude. I mean, you know what? The reality of the situation, in my opinion, is I hate some of these. Awards like Baker Mayfield, in my opinion, is top 3 in MVP voting, or it should be. He's not going to be close to that, but he's having an insane season, man. Yep. Despite all the injuries, 24 touchdowns and 9 interceptions. And the guy is just, it doesn't matter who he's playing. He's been competitive every game this year, and it's been really good for him, man. Mm-hmm. And
found a home.
despite the Panthers playing pretty decent right now, dude, Baker Mayfield went into New York, who had every reason to keep that game close, and he fucking spanked them.
He destroyed them.
And I could just see it happening again. It's not like the Panthers are good, obviously. And I know, I'm telling you, everyone and their mother is going to be on the Panthers this week because they kept it close against the Chiefs.
Yes,
I don't think so, man. The Tampa Bay Bucs have proved that they will blow you out of the water if you are a bad football team, and they do not care. And Mike Evans is back now. This has a Baker. Do you take Baker Mayfield's overs, like, and just over touchdowns, over passing yards, and you just, and you're eating steak and lobster at night?
I agree. J.C. Horn can't handle Mike Evans, who is another week healed from that hammy. Don't be prisoners of the moment, man. Y'all let recency bias really determine too much of how you lay the wood here. Yes, Kansas City did not play well. Yes, Kansas City could have lost that game in Carolina, but that is not enough for me to think for a second that the Bucs will not blow this team away. I'm sorry. Let's be honest, man. And I'm not one of these KC homers. The Chiefs are not good. The Chiefs are opportunistic team with dynamic talent and fantastic coaching, and that's five wins. Right there, that's five wins. Let's say, for instance, everything went wrong for Kansas City this year, Spencer. What's their record right now? 5-6?
Yeah, 500.
You see what I mean? They're the Bucks. They're the Bucks. And so barring them flipping the light on like they did last year, it could be in trouble. So don't get gassed off what Carolina did last week versus them. They caught them at a bad time. People are catching Kansas City at the right time because their secondary is falling apart. The defense not playing well. Don't be gassed. I took the Giants last week with confidence, and it got steamrolled. That Tommy DeVito, chicken parm, that stuff went out the window in the first quarter. Baker Mayfield is a G. He's a top five quarterback in the NFL right now, whether you want to believe it or not, guys. He is. He does more with less, and he's every bit as good as some of these other guys that you are anointing great quarterbacks. It's just a fact. So, and even when they lose, they keep it close. If they would have got the ball first in Kansas City, they would have won the game. If Todd Bowles had any balls, they would have went for two and won the game. They left that game on the field for Kansas City. This is the type of wins that Kansas City has been getting. Okay, the Bucs had that game won, and I think they're gonna roll this team. Honestly, Jatavion Sanders broke his neck. I mean, he's all messed up. I'm not so sure about their other rookie wide receiver, Jalen Coker. I mean, that doesn't leave much but Adam Thielen and Chuba Hubbard. I mean, again, guys, I don't expect 2, 3, 4 players not named like Joe Montana, Jerry Rice, John Taylor, and Roger Craig to be able to win games in 2024. It takes a team, and the Bucs will play hard tomorrow. I'm going to lay that 5.5. I think they win this game by a touchdown.
All right, we have the Los Angeles Rams are going to New Orleans. 2.5 points for the Rams. It's just tough. I hate doing this because New Orleans is so good at home. Like, they just play different kind of football. And I do feel like there's going to be a lot of people on the Saints in this game because of that. But I'm going to go with my gut feeling, and I'm going to say the Rams win this game. The Saints aren't good. Oh, man. Alvin Kamara, take his overs, man. He's going to have a big game. I could see a shootout, man. And if there's a shootout between these two teams, I'm going to take the Rams. I mean, I like the Eagles, obviously. So that was a expected win for me in that game. But this is not the Eagles, dude. This is the Saints. They're terrible. The Rams need to get back to 500. They're playing a lot of 500 football. They're going to have a bounce back week. I mean, the Rams are the bounce back week kings, man. And that's why they're 500. It's like a bad loss, a good win, a bad loss, a good, you know, it's like they can never like play up to the best of the best competition. But I just don't see Derek Carr having a massive, this is the kind of game where everyone's like, Derek Carr's at home against the Saints. And that's when he puts up his worst performance. This is one of those two pick performances from Derek Carr to ruin the game for them. I only need a field goal to win this game. I like, give me the Rams, man. I think they're going to put up enough points, and I don't think the Saints can keep up.
I'm going to take the Saints plus 2.5. I don't have any real reasoning. I'm not a big believer in the Rams. I thought getting the Rams back together, Nacua, Cooper Kupp, Matt Stafford, I thought I'd be seeing more from them. You know what I mean? I expect to see more, and I haven't. They've been good. You know, they've been good. They're a nice 500 team fighting for their lives to get in the playoffs. That's who they are, and that's all they're ever going to be. Done a really good job replacing Aaron Donald. I like Verse. I like Fisk. Solid, good team. Something about the Saints in their building. You know what I mean? And Taysom Hill comes out of nowhere. I mean, he comes out of the freaking phone booth, and here he is. 50 points out of nowhere. It's just one of those games where, like, MVS catches a 60-yard bomb. I mean, they are just bums. They're just bums, but somehow they ruin bets. The Saints ruin more tickets than anyone in the NFL. They just do. And you're going to give me points. I mean, I know Derek Carr is a bum, but, like, he's a bum that wins. Or else he wouldn't be the starting quarterback. He's better than any other player in that quarterback room. It just kind of is what it is. And they do less with more. In the dome, at home, I don't know, man. You're going to give me 2.5? I could see this being a one-point game either way. I'll take those points. Zero confidence, mind you. Zero confidence. But I just see something stupid happening. I mean, no one could have called Taysom Hill having 50 points. You know what I mean? No one. And look what happened. Rams just don't do it for me this year. I don't know what it is about them. And they have good players, but, I mean, just not as good as they used to be. And I know Marshawn Lattimore is gone. There's just no reasoning behind me taking the Saints here. But everyone is just like the Jets game. Everybody is going to take the Rams here. Everyone. And home dogs pay dividends. If the only reasoning you have for betting sometimes is home dogs pay dividends, guys, sometimes that's enough. Guys play different when they're home. I'm going to take them and I'm going to pull and pray.
All right, we have the Philadelphia Eagles going to Baltimore. Oh, wow. This should be the Sunday night game, but I get it. Is Brock Purdy even back? I'm not even sure.
They're going to try to push him out there.
Yeah, they're going to wheel him out if they have to. Yeah. But this is a 3-point favorites for the Ravens. I like the Eagles in this game. I think they could easily win it. I don't know why this isn't like a 1-point spread. What have the Eagles done but win football games? And
Eagles too.
Is the Ravens going to be the reason that they can completely stop Saquon Barkley? I don't know. I kind of don't believe that. You know, it's crazy to think about how good Saquon Barkley has and Derrick Henry has.
MVP.
He has 1,300 yards, Derrick Henry. I mean, they're like neck and neck, man.
MVPs.
Kind of nuts. I mean, but when I look at these two teams, I don't know, man. I they're both trending in the right direction. This is going to be a good game, but I just the Ravens are like the letdown kings, man. Right when you think that they're going to take the reins and be like the Super Bowl contenders, they just put up a stinker. And I think the Eagles are going to be ready for this game. I really do. Another Bird Bowl kind of game. The Ravens are at home. You know, everyone's going to think they're unstoppable. And then I just can see them like not putting up a good performance. Mm-hmm. And it's not a good matchup for them. We've talked about this. If you can get Derrick Henry out of the game early, the Ravens just kind of fall apart. They can't depend on that passing game. And I could see that happening here. I really like the Eagles, man. I think they're destined to go back to the Super Bowl this year. I think they're that good. I think Jalen Carter has a big game. I think Lamar Jackson has a few bad passes in this game. And I think Saquon Barkley eats again, man. This Saquon Barkley is the current favorite to win the MVP. If he's not, he needs to be.
Well, it's a quarterback-driven award, but we all know, real ones know, he's the MVP. Period.
Yeah, I like that. I'm getting a field goal for the Eagles. I feel really good about that.
I love the Eagles here, too. And let Devonta Smith get on the field, and I'll love him even more. He's a GTD with that hammy, but he practiced in a limited fashion on Thanksgiving. He might be out there, man. Saquon's hard to stop. The Eagles are one of these teams that they just win with talent. If they ever got their coaching together, man, they'd be really unstoppable. They're on a heater right now. Ravens won big last week. I just don't trust them. I just don't trust their defense. Their pass defense is not good. Anything happens to Kyle Hamilton, you're going to throw all over them. I'm serious. They're not good. Roquan Smith, he was out. I don't know if he'll be back. You know, losing Patrick Queen has killed this team. The defense, not good. Don't be fooled. This ain't Ray Lewis and Murderer's Row anymore, guys. Their defense gives up big plays all the time. They're very overrated. If they get knocked out of the playoffs, their defense is going to be the reason why. Now, they're home. I don't really think that matters. Honestly, I saw the Raiders go there and win a game. So, I like the Eagles here getting the points. I really, really do. I like the Eagles defensive front stopping Derrick Henry more than I like the Baltimore defensive front stopping Saquon. And I think that's what it's going to boil down to. Both quarterbacks are going to run and make plays. Both quarterbacks are going to throw the ball all over the yard. But I like the Eagles wide receivers a lot more than I like what's happening in Baltimore. They're simply getting 3 points because they're home and they won last week under the lights, which is fine. But I think that Jalen Hurts is very good too, man. I know Lamar is having another wonderful season. Don't get me wrong, man. Lamar is not one of my favorite people, but I'm not one to not give flowers. He's an unbelievable athlete. I just don't think he's a very good quarterback. But with the ball in his hands, man, the boy is nice. But I'm still taking those 3 points on the road because I think the Eagles are headed to the NFC Championship game in Detroit. I've been standing on this for almost a year, and I think it's going to happen. Fly, Eagles, fly.
All right, we have the Sunday night game. It is the 49ers going to Buffalo. Now, the 49ers, it was actually my best bet last week to go against the 49ers, and that was a big-time win, man, because they're not very good. They're free-falling right now.
They're bums. I told you, this is the year that the Niners fall apart. All you guys laughed at me. They're bums. Dude, CMC is done, bro. He's done. It's over. Guys, it's over. You had one play in the Super Bowl, and you make that play, and you win the Super Bowl. Guys, it doesn't get any closer than that. And you couldn't get it done. It's over. It's shut. The window is shut. It's shut. It's done. At some point, you have to face facts. Niner fans, I'm talking to all of you. At some point, you have to face facts. I got to go on a little rant here for a second, Spencer, because I hear this all the time from this Niner faithful. Okay? Guys, Steve Wilks wasn't the problem. You guys made him the fall guy. And it's been free fall ever since. You paid Brandon Ayuk like a bunch of dummies. He's out. You paid Trent Williams like a bunch of dummies. He's 40. Brock Purdy's going to get overpaid. He's hurt. Deeble's overpaid. Trade him. CMC's got Germany all over his legs. Like, guys, it's over. This is my best bet. I'm going to let you finish. I just had to get that out.
No, I agree. I mean, Nick Bosa's out in this game. Trent Williams is out. Obviously, you know, they've had some season-long injuries for guys out. I mean, their injury list looks like a book at this point. You could publish it. So I know the Buffalo Bills have their own kind of issues that they're dealing with, you know, in terms of injuries, but nothing out of this world. Keon Coleman is questionable. Dalton Kincaid is out, but they have good depth at the tight end position. They'll be fine, man. This is a dangerous, dangerous Bills team, dude. This is a team that can easily go to the Super Bowl, and this is the best they've looked. They shed that dead weight off this team, man, and they look like a different team.
Yep.
And it's worked out for them. Less is more in football. I really believe that, dude. Mm-hmm. The skill positions, I'm not going to say are overrated, but you win Super Bowls with the trenches, man, and they just focus on that so much more. Besides the fact that Von Miller is having a half-decent season for them now, which is obviously what they, you know, put all of their money into. So he's got like a handful of sacks this year, but it's just been a better effort for them overall. They're spreading the ball out. They have a lot of talent. They have good talent, you know, not superstar talent. They have good talent all around. James Cook is good. They've just strung it together. And then you just lean on your superstar quarterback. That's how you win football games. And that's how they've won this year. So I like them too. 6 points against the 49ers seems like insane. If you were to say that 2 years ago, but it's not 2 years ago. It's right now. And the 49ers season is, from in my eyes, over. It doesn't matter it's who's over. Playing quarterback for them.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. I don't care if Brock Purdy goes out there with half a shoulder. I mean, it doesn't matter. Brandon Allen, whatever that guy's name. It doesn't matter. The window of opportunity, it's shut. It's done. The Niners are full-on rebuild mode, and they don't even know it yet. I'd already be fielding calls for Debo. I would be. Start fresh. You got Ricky Pearsall. You know what I mean? Juwan Jennings is very good. You're not out of it yet, but you're going to have to shed some dead weight. The Bills, they shed their dead weight. They got all the divas off their team. I'm telling you right now, the team that beats Buffalo in the playoffs is winning the Super Bowl. And if no one beats them in the playoffs, they are winning the Super Bowl. Because they have done what Kansas City did. They got rid of all the – they got rid of Tyreek, then the one that got rid of Steph. It's the same thing. Less is more.
Tre'Davious White. And
they got rid of all the bums.
All these guys who are just names.
The guys who they could get rid of. They couldn't get rid of Von Miller because they paid him too much, but Von Miller's producing. Dude, they have great players, man. A.J. Epinesa's good. They got rid of all the bums, man. Micah Hyde. They got him out of it. I mean, they get these guys off the team. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. I kind of feel like Josh Allen pretty much sold his soul to the devil for this year. This is it. He's like, I don't know what else I have to do. So I'm going to sign on the dotted line. Seriously. I mean, if there is a team in the NFL right now that needs a Super Bowl more, I'm waiting to hear it. If the Buffalo Bills do not go to the Super Bowl this year, they're never going to go. Guys, this is it. You got an injured Kansas City team that's not that good. Cincinnati is trash. The Ravens can be had, especially if you take them on the road. I mean, this is it. Bills Mafia is ready for war. Send Bills Mafia to Ukraine. The war would end. It would end tomorrow. And so I'm taking the Bills. They are my best bet. I'm taking them with confidence. Highmark Stadium is a very, very difficult place to play. The Niners are done. Guys, it's over. It's over. The CMC you're hoping to save you does not exist anymore. I'm sorry.
Last game, Monday Night Football. It's the Denver Broncos. They're at home against the Cleveland Browns. This is a short line, too.
I love the Broncos here.
I'm not a big fan of the Broncos. I mean, they beat up on bad teams and lose to good teams, but yeah, the Browns are not a good team. You know, that game horrible. Against the Steelers, that's a divisional NFL classics type of game. The Browns are not good. Okay, the Raiders beat the Browns with like stooges back there. Like, this is not a like non-beatable team, whatever you want to call them. I think that the Broncos absolutely demolished them. Two interception game for Jameis Winston. I feel like there's going to be a good amount of action on the Browns because everyone's going to be like, Jameis Winston is, you know, had a great game in the snow, and
they're going to get.
I'm sorry, but this is a very professional team is not the way I want to put it, but very well organized team in the Denver Broncos. This is not a divisional matchup. The Broncos aren't home. They're going to be super fired up. There's no. I think this is a complete blowout. So I really love the Denver Broncos at home here. I think they take care of business, and I think. Yeah, the Browns just take a bad loss here. Not a bad loss because they should lose, but I think they're going to lose badly.
Mm-hmm. I agree. The Broncos are the team that has exceeded expectations more than anyone could have possibly imagined when we sat here doing our NFL draft show. I was giving them 3 or 4 wins, and no one was thinking Bo Nix was any good. He's going to be a third-round quarterback, and he ended up going 12th, 11th. And look at him now. He's going to be Rookie of the Year, and he's going to cement that here Monday night. Bo Nix is better than you think. Run, throw, doesn't turn a ball over. Super Bowl winning head coach. Coaching matters. Decent run game. Excellent defense. They have lapses, but they are an excellent defense, especially at home. I'm worried when Kansas City goes there that could be an L. I mean, Sertan is one of the best. One of the best. Versus a team that got a huge win in the snow. Nick Chubb on one leg, recovering. Jameis Winston, 30 touchdowns, 30 interceptions. Cedric Tillman's got knocked into next year. Like, I mean, I worry about guys like David Njoku a little bit because he's just a beast, but not to the tune of, you know, covering 5.5. They're just, dude, the Browns are not good. They're not good. And Denver is better than people think, man. The AFC West here soon literally could be the best division in football. If the Raiders ever get their act together, and the performance the Raiders put on yesterday, they should have won the game. Go get a head coach or keep this bum and get a decent OC that's an X's and O's guy and then get yourself a franchise quarterback. Get Shedeur Sanders. Now you got Shedeur Sanders, Brock Bowers. You can find a running back in the sixth round and give these other guys some run. Give, you know, I mean, they found this Sincere McCormick guy in Walmart the other day. I mean, it doesn't take much. Seven round running backs win Super Bowls. Ask Isaiah Pacheco. I mean, AFC West is on its way back. But back to Denver. They're better than you think, man. At Mile High, tough place to play. They don't give it up easy. They don't give it up easy. And touchdown wins, two field goals win you money. Touchdown wins you money. I really, really like Bo Nix this year. I got to be honest. He's better than I thought he was going to be. I didn't think he was going to be very good. Some guys in college, I've seen Bo Nix play in college. It doesn't transfer well to the NFL, a la Marcus Mariota. It just lends to being like a career backup. That's not who Bo Nix is, man. Bo Nix is go get it. And Denver's got weapons that they don't even use. You know what I mean? Marvin Mims. Mims is good. Troy Franklin. These guys are better than serviceable. They're good players. They hardly even use these guys. Imagine when they really get it going. They're going to be tough to stop, man. I'll tell you right now, when Kansas City goes to Denver, I might take the Denver Broncos. I might. Something about that Mile High mystique that you know, Spencer, it slows a lot of teams down. That's a slate, guys. Week 13. It's crazy. Time for the Wiz's ticket. Time for you guys to cash in your wife's wedding ring. Let's hear it.
Here's my best bet. The Chargers +5. I really like that. I mean, I'm not a huge fan of the Falcons this week, and I doubt they blow out the Chargers. That would be seriously shocking. I think the Chargers are due for a bounce-back game against a not very good team. I like the Colts. I mean, I'm getting a field goal against the Patriots. How are the Patriots going to win by a touchdown against the Colts? That would be absolute insanity, in my opinion. And then Monday Night Football, we just talked about it. I just need the Denver Broncos to beat the Cleveland Browns at home. That feels like a lock to me. Those are my three. You win a little bit more than what I have here on the screen. So, because normally I buy a few extra points here and there, but the numbers ended up kind of working out in my favor this week. So that's my best bet.
I like this ticket. I think Atlanta wins by 3. I think the Colts win outright, and I think the Broncos mob. I like this ticket a lot. Did you win your ticket last week? I think you did.
I think I did, actually.
Yeah, I think you did. These Wiz tickets, guys, they're good, man.
I love these. I do this for basketball. I should really post them somewhere. I love three-team teasers. They're very fun. They're very fun to do.
These Wiz tickets, they're cashing
in. You win a little bit more than double your money, so all you have to do is be right more than you're wrong to make money. That's kind of how I view it. I don't like to go for these Hail Mary tickets. I'd rather just, like, you know, a little teaser, you win more, you win double your money back. And again, all you have to be is right more than you're wrong. So I like those kinds of bets.
No, this is solid. I like it a lot. World of Matches bringing the heat every week, guys. Week 13, the weeks are flying by. We are getting ready for the playoffs here. We will continue to do the show for you guys every Saturday. It'll be posted maybe about noon every week, between noon and 4. Like, subscribe, share the videos. We appreciate all the love. You guys enjoy the games. On behalf of World of Matches, I'm Dexter Reed. That is Spencer the Wiz. We are out.
See you guys.